request Sri N. Murali, President of the Music Academy, to welcome the gathering.
Good evening, Namaskaram. On behalf of the Indira Sivasailam Foundation and the Music Academy, let me extend our Navaratri greetings and extend a very warm welcome to every one of you to this special event. This event, as you know, is an annual feature to commemorate someone who was so passionate about Carnatic music, someone who was part and parcel of this December music season at the Music Academy, where she unfailingly and unobtrusively attended every single festival except in the last 2 years of her life. This, ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, is in commemoration of Srimati Indira Sivasailam, who was not only an avid rasika, a trained musician, but also a valued member of the Music Academy, its patron, where she has also instituted an endowment for the best sub-senior vocalist during the December season. Therefore, in 2010, in memory of this wonderful lady, her daughter, Srimati Mallika Srinivasan, instituted this Indira Sivasailam Endowment Fund, which during the last 5 years, in association with the Music Academy, has during Navaratri this special event. In fact, this has now become so well entrenched in the hearts and souls of the people here that music rasikas feel that it is a special and integral part of their Navaratri celebrations itself. Apart from Srimati Indira Sivasailam, the whole family has been involved in supporting our rich heritage and tradition with, as I said, Srimati Mallika Srinivasan taking inspiration from her mother and supporting our traditional fine arts, classical fine arts in a big way. Not just that, she has of course been a big benefactor of the Music Academy, but then if today the Music Academy's ambience and infrastructure and the facilities are of a high standard, I must here recall the contribution of Venu Srinivasan, who really catalyzed that whole process in 2006, and in these last 8 years, we have come a long way. In an auditorium, which is a heritage structure, it has its limitations, but we could do what we within that limitations, and the whole family has been supportive of us. As you all know, the previous recipients of this prestigious award and the person who give the concert here have been Sudha Ragunathan, Sanjay Subrahmanyan, Aruna Sairam. Last year it was Bombay Jayashri, and now it is none other than Sri T.M. Krishna, who is the youngest recipient of this award so far. What does one say about Krishna? He was precocious at a very young age, and as was said, he started learning music at the age of 6 from a very eminent guru, Bhagavatulu Sita Rama Sharma, and later on some of his nuances were honed by Vidwan Chengalpet Ranganathan, after which he trained under the Doyen Semangudi Srinivasayyar for 7 or 8 years, and then went out into the wide world. Not surprisingly, his first concert was at the age of 12 at the Spirit of Youth Festival of the Music Academy, which really, after that, he has not looked back. He is all of 38 years, but to have attained, to have reached and attained this eminence and reached the top echelons of Carnatic music says a lot about his abilities. He is a very fine musician. He is rooted, or his foundation is in rich tradition, but he is also one who dares to innovate within the framework. Dare I say that? Within the classical framework, he is one who also challenges conventional practices, structured rules, and whether one agrees with his views or not, he's fearless. What one needs to appreciate is his honesty of his views and courage of conviction. I think Krishna's creativity is not finished yet. He's exploring himself, his music, and we don't know where he will end, but he has a long, bright, big career ahead of him, and there couldn't have been a worthier recipient this year than Sri T.M. Krishna. I have now talked about the endowment, about the recipient. Let me now pay my tribute in fond remembrance to a very great musician, a musical genius, who left us a few days ago at a very young age. He adapted a Western instrument to the nuances, the intricacies of Carnatic music like no other musician before, or I doubt if any other musician after him will play Carnatic music on the mandolin as mandolin U. Srinivas. I must also recall to this audience that his association with the Music Academy has been for over three decades, starting right from 1983, when he performed continuously during every single festival except in 2002, I don't know the reasons now, we must look back, but otherwise, he was a very fine human being, and the music, Carnatic, world of Carnatic music has lost a real genius and a maestro. And but the music will go on, people like T.M. Krishna will go to different orbits now. And therefore, once again, I thank every one of you for responding to this invitation and being here. In fact, this Navaratri event has become so important that now people always associate this Navaratri with this event. And just now, as a matter of curiosity, some people were rushing into the auditorium to take their seats before, because they said they prefer seats to the food. So that is a very rare thing. But it also attests to the popularity and attraction of T.M. Krishna, because they don't want to listen to him without a proper seat. So once again, we are honored and delighted that all of you have shown up here in such large numbers, and we look forward to a very enthralling evening. Thank you.